On to another interesting segment. Naqishni is a social network website created to be used as a well-structured and user-friendly platform for social interactions in debates and discussions. I'm joined today with one of the members of and the co-founders of Naqishni, Mansour, Hassan. Hello and welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hello, Mansour. Would you tell me more about the idea? How did you come up with
it? The idea was born during the Egyptian Revolution. We realized that people in Egypt became very politically aware. Everywhere you go, people are always talking about politics, talking about the current events going on. So we realized that people were very politically aware.
But so more or less a platform for grabbing the attention of youth groups to be involved in debates. And not only on the political aspects, that this is what I understand understood from you, it's and on several aspects too.
Basically, users go on and they debate any subject they want, but the debates are created on trends. Right now, of course, because of the revolution, everything going on in Egypt, everyone's discussing politics. So now if you go on the website, you'd realize that most of the debates are on politics. But users can create debates about anything, sports, technology.
But who did create this this website or this social platform with you? Who was the co-creator with you?
It's me and a couple of partners. We have also one of our partners, our development group called MASH. They create websites, and we came up with the idea together, and they developed the website for us.
And what about the since we were speaking about the top top demand maybe on the political arena. How are you leveraging icons maybe or figures to grab the attentions of the users towards your social platform?
In this period we are focusing on getting a lot of politicians or public figures to join the website. We managed to get a couple. We want them to be active on our website so people could see what they think in specific things going on in the country.
But there are any rules maybe to join the dialogue or to join the debate on your platform?
There are no rules. We try to keep it civilized.
Just topics.
The users put the topics themselves. We just try to control. We have one button on there. It's the report button. If people start fighting and start
using
bad words or language, they press the report button and it automatically disappears from in front of them. If we get a couple more than one report, us as admins, we remove the statement completely.
How different is it from the Facebook or maybe Twitter?
Naqishni is more, we focus on the structure of the actual platform. Users go on there and it's just about debating. So the difference between Naqishni and Twitter and, or Facebook, I'd say, is the structure. People put the topic of the discussion and you're either agreeing or disagreeing with the topic. So you have people on one side and people on the other side, and users can go in and see. It's obvious which side you're on when you see the
And how are you leveraging the engine of Facebook probably? Leveraging the engine of Facebook and the enormous amount of users that are using Facebook to drive traffic to your website? Let me explain this again. How are you leveraging the Facebook enormous amounts of users that are existing on Facebook in order to get some traffic from those users through your social platform?
We use Facebook ads. We have our page on Facebook, and we always put our debate topics on the page for users, for our followers on Facebook to see.
Twitter,
and when they see the debate topic and they if it's interesting for them, they press on it and they move to our website.
But what are the most debated or most discussed topics on Naqishni?
We have a couple recently. First of all, in the time of the the presidential elections, we had the debate of versus Mohamed Morsi versus Ahmed Shafi. That was huge. And now, of course, we are working on a campaign called Naqish Dasturak, which means debate your constitution. This was very important in this time. Users would go on to the website, and debate the constitution and vote yes or no on the whole constitution. Also, they would debate each amendment, not just the constitution as a whole, but debate and understand the whole constitution, each amendment. Mm-hmm. You would go on, you read the amendment and debate whether you agree or disagreed with the amendment.
With each article?
With each article,
so
yeah.
So that's about 260 yes. something articles.
Exactly, yeah.
A lot of debate.
Yes. Yeah.
How are you leveraging the technology since it's more or less a debate platform? How are you leveraging the technology in order to use some additional tools for the people who are debating?
We have people, when they put your arguments in debates, you can also support your arguments with viral videos from YouTube. Yes. Or pictures. Uh-huh. So that is a way that to, like, you can use anything to put your argument on a specific topic, not just write your argument, you can also use other things.
Usually discussions now on Facebook specifically are really intense and harsh. You're turning out to be harsh debates or harsh discussions. Are you thinking to implement any sort of tools that may help, you know, create this sort of dialogue or bridge between the gaps, between the different point of views?
I think that the misunderstandings and the clashes happen on Facebook because of the structure of the website itself. Mm-hmm. It is not a website for people to have, like, different opinions. Usually, if you put an argument, the other arguments are come down and like in a sequence, yes. which is not for convenient for debating. So, on Nakishni, when you have two sides, we realize that the manner of the debating is much more civilized, and people understand, like, they want to listen to your point of view, to respond, and sometimes even maybe that they can get convinced with your arguments.
But do the people participating in such debates or such discussions actually have their changes or the views changed after these discussions or debates?
Yeah, sometimes if the person on the other side is able to convince mm-hmm. one of the users, why not? I guess that is what the goal of the website. You want people to understand other point of views of the person on the other side. Mm-hmm. Maybe not completely transformed mm-hmm. to the other side, but at least get an understanding of what that person is saying and where he's coming from. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. that is important for us as the developers of the website. We think that was the purpose of making the website yes. to begin with.
Mm-hmm. What are you seeing in terms of positive outcomes from your initiative?
That, like what I said before, like, people are starting to discuss certain topics rather than just fighting and closing and started, like, not talking to each other anymore. Mm-hmm. So people are starting to converse more.
But is there anything that you learn as a monitor of these discussions?
Learn from
personally?
From the website?
Yes. Or?
No, but I'm just, I think
you never participate in such debates?
I debate, I'm very politically active, mm-hmm. so I do, and but as me, as my name, I use my name, I don't use the website. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I learned that discussion is very important in this period of time, mm-hmm. and I think it will help for this country to evolve and to move on.
Right, finally I'd like to thank you very much, Mansour Hassan, co-founder and member of Naqishni. It was a great pleasure to have you with us tonight.
Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you very much. And let's move on now to another segment, but right after this break.
Developing Dahshur region, which is being implemented by the Ministry of State for Environmental Affairs and the Ministry of Tourism in cooperation with Italy and the United Nations Developmental Organizations, is considered one of the most significant developing projects which are aimed at preserving the environment and promoting its performance at the Governorate of Giza. One of the main axes of developing Dahshur is the preparation of the region, which is the aim of announcing it as a national protectorate as it gathers Dahshur Lake, which is rich of environmental and biological diversification.
بحيرة دشور هي من المناطق الحيوية الهامة جدا جدا جدا، واللي الاتحاد الدولي لصون الطبيعة أو لحماية الطبيعة كان صنفها بأن هي من المناطق المهددة.
Mr. Mohammed Youssef, an aide at Resources Development and World Heritage Project in Dashur, says the lake of Dashur is viewed as one of the most important and vital regions, which is being classified by the International Federation for Nature Protection as one of the most threatened regions. At the same time, it is the only remaining region in the area. Its scientific name in the seasonal lake studies tackled by Dashur Development Project has resulting in finding that the place is rich with a biological diversification, whether being plants or animals. And studies recorded the existence of 40 kinds of plants that belong to 25 families, in addition to the existence of sladdum animals. The region is expected to be announced as a natural protectorate soon, and consequently it will be controlled by law number 102 to the year 83, which is specialized in administering natural protectorates in Egypt. By announcing the Dashur region as a natural protectorate, this will guarantee preserving its unique and seldom biological diversification. This is Sahar Talawi reporting for Nile Cruise.